NMRC, CT and MRI centers have done 1 million CTs and MRI, and I'm very sure Pogakatta private sector would have done another 1.5. To put this in perspective, our neighboring state, which is definitely not second to Tamil Nadu in most aspect, their government, all the hospitals put together, have done 2.2 lakh CT scans and MRIs. I'm very sure, this particular pricing will reduce the demand in this particular state, and private sector also would find it very difficult because they expect a certain level of demand to recover their own capital costs as well as satisfy the needs of consumers. In this aspect, I would say that Tamil Nadu government has definitely created a success story by pricing its services either free or even if it prices for a fee, it has priced it in such a way that it is well within the affordability of the consumers. Then I come to the third point on health insurance. There have been various health insurance models in this country, and I think Prakash anyway in his lecture will explain in detail. I saw in the panel of speakers a lot of representatives are there from TPS also. What distinguishes Tamil Nadu's insurance model dovetailed with the government of India's Ayushman Bharat scheme from the models which are implemented across various states in Tamil Nadu? I would say that there are 5 or 6 unique features how our design has benefited the consumers of our state both qualitatively and quantitatively in a much better than manner than others. The first is the coverage. Tamil Nadu government genuinely believes that anyone who cannot afford a healthcare insurance on their own should be covered by government health insurance. This would be clearly proved by the fact that our coverage of health insurance is for 1.5 crore beneficiaries out of an entitled individual households of 2.1 crore, which makes our coverage close to 70%. If you combine this with the other state-sponsored insurance schemes for, say, government employees and pensioners, which cover another 2 million households, we cover 1.7 crore families out of 2.1 crore households in this state, which means that there is no other state which has had a higher coverage of health insurance. Technically, around 84 to 85% of households in Tamil Nadu are covered by one form of government insurance or other. Of course, there is always a mismatch of numbers in the sense that many people are not aware of the entitlement and they have misplaced the card. Even in the worst case scenario, it's 80%. Number two, the cover. In terms of what diseases are these consumers entitled for coverage? I think sir again touched upon the rejection by the insurance providers in case. I wouldn't say that it is not a problem in government insurance schemes also. The problem still exists on a minor scale. But the cover has been designed in such a way that our existing illnesses and other problems which are for high cost, which create a high cost to the consumers, are all covered under the insurance without fail. Why is insurance costly? For consumers? Because in many societies, insurance has been covering everything. That is the flaw in the insurance model. The insurance model is very good, it's very affordable if it is designed to cover a low frequency but high cost events. But when the insurance model is designed to cover a high frequency but low cost models, the frequency of strikes becomes so high that one particular sick patient who entitles to a low cost event again and again is loading the cost on all the consumers. That is why you would see that all the insurance model which universally cover everything have become increasingly prohibitively costly for consumers. But Tamil Nadu's model is unique in the sense that it does not cover the illnesses which are of low cost, which can be covered in government hospitals free of cost. That is, if I have an asthma, if I have an, you know, if I need an, you know, yeah, treatment with an intravenous, you know, say theophylline, I'm with a nebulizer, there's no need that I need to access an insurance-based healthcare system. That treatment is freely available in, you know, government hospitals. But if I have a cancer of lung, then that is something which will be available in government, you know, system. But if there is a waiting list there, if you need a higher method of treatment, if you need a more complicated, you know, intervention, then we empower the consumer to use the treatment which is available in the private sector. Private sector also. This dual treatment has helped us to bring down the cost for us, in the sense that our premiums continue to be low. Then the third point on insurance is what consumers repeat again and again: value for money. Does this particular insurance model represent value for money to the government, to the consumers? How do you, you know, calculate value for money in an insurance? There are, I mean, umpteen measures to calculate it, but the most common measure is the claims ratio. If I have paid X rupees as an insurance premium, I mean, for on behalf of the community, how much has insurance benefited the community? Has it benefited 0.8x, 1.5x? I mean, at 1.5x, the insurance company will go broke. I mean, Prakash also faced the situation for 2 years under one of our schemes. So, but at 0.6x, then consumers are going to come and question us. Why are we wasting that, you know, 40% of your, you know, premium by paying to the insurance? You could have, you know, used it to, you know, to deliver the healthcare on your own. But our design, based on what I have explained, has benefited consumers exactly to the amount of what we have empowered the consumers to avail the services. From in the last decade where this our insurance scheme, this intervention has been going on, the range of claims ratio for Tamil Nadu has varied from 91% to 104%. The average is 0.96, that is 96%, which means that if Tamil Nadu government has paid 100 crores insurance to any insurance vendor, the consumer has benefited to the extent of 96 crores. So the remaining 4 crores, you know, there's always an, you know, a transaction cost, there's an organizational and administration cost involved. So I have no hesitation in saying that our insurance model has brought out the best value for money, not only for the government, but for the consumer. The third point is, how does insurance help to reinvent or improve our own public healthcare system? If you evaluate various group insurance schemes in, you know, in different parts of the countries, which are taking place in different, you know, set of, you know, set the societies, the share of public healthcare system in insurance, basically, if there are 10 lakh people availing medical healthcare in OPR inpatients in Tamil Nadu today, normally 55% avail them in government hospitals and around 45% available in private, you know, hospitals. In number, I'm not telling it this in value terms, but in number terms. So when I implement an insurance, whether this entire consumer group is going to avail it only from private setup or a substantial part of it come to government setup, this ratio varies from state to state. Even an advanced state like Maharashtra, I mean, off late I had an interaction last month with Maharashtra, you know, health sector ago. They say that the share of their public health, public health hospital share in the overall insurance has been running around 9 to 10%, which means that 90% of the consumers in one state, even if they are entitled to avail the service both in government as well as private hospitals, they go to private hospitals. The same number for Tamil Nadu is 37%. That is, when I pay a premium of say 1,000 crores to tell a company that you entitle my consumers to for a services of 1,000 crores, 370 crores worth of services are being consumed in government hospitals. And this particular money comes back to the government hospitals. It is used to strengthen the government hospitals, to buy new equipment, to incentivize doctors so that they can deliver the services even better over a period of time. This plowback arrangement has enormously helped government hospitals to improve their services to an extent. I would never use the word on par with private sector, because you know I know that private sector is always one step ahead of government. They expect it to be ahead, but still, I would say that we are catching up fast. And I really foresee maybe within half a decade, maybe in 5 years, the share of government in this is likely to approach 50%. Even in this, when it comes to a high-end treatment, like in doing the break we were discussing about interventions in nuclear medicine, linear accelerators, say transplant surgeries, these are the areas where the government health sector may be found a bit lacking, and the consumer may exhibit a preference for private sector. But I assure you that it's changing. From say 6 cath labs for angioplasty, by this year end, we will have 20. From 1 linear accelerator for cancer care, by this year we'll go to 9. From 64 CT scan centers, we have now gone to 86 CT scan centers. In everywhere, we plan to give the consumer a choice in terms of an easy access in a government system which is close to their home, on a quality which is equal to private sector. I sincerely hope that these efforts of governments will bring hope. And in future, we will definitely strive for a situation where the consumer, when he exercises the choice between a government and a private care healthcare service provider, quality should not be a differentiator. When a person